Welcome to the show, everybody, on this glorious
welcome, summer,
hot, humid-ish day.
It is not. You're
such
a whiner.
The flies are starting to show up. You know what? I really wish you would just quit yapping at me because...
Why don't you get a new co-host,
I'm going to make room for another yapper.
You big jerk.
Okay,
should
let me...
Should I be a yapper? I am not a yapper.
What's going on?
Well, listen.
That remains to be seen.
Bottom line, welcome to CJ's first cooking show. Ladies and gentlemen, this... is Betty,
okay.
And she is co-hosting with me on my show, and she's going to show me something delicious to make.
Ciao Bella.
Is that what it is?
Ciao Bella. I'm going to teach CJ how to make a real pizza, not a flatbread, but a pizza, like a little authentic Italian. I'm bringing a little Italian to your life.
Maybe he'll listen to you. You know, word to the wise.
He doesn't listen to me.
So, yeah, we're going to jump right into this, right?
Yep.
Well, you know,
I'm so excited. You're
on my show. Let's not forget. My show. Let's not forget. And on my show, we start everything off with a certain little bang.
Mm-hmm. Before we bang that, just remember that because of my show, your show's gonna actually get some views and nice comments.
Them's a fighting word.
So all that's right. Ding to that, CJ.
All right, bring it, you
me?
Big jerk.
Oh,
hope
boy.
It sings you. I should set up an electric charge on that one next time. Let's do this.
So mean. Alright, so to make a real tomato sauce, nothing like out of a jar or something, no, what's Nate say?
Rouse.
He used to say
it's Rose. Called Rayos. Everyone knows that.
This guy, obviously. Okay.
We're gonna take some nice San Marzano tomatoes. They have to be a very good brand.
Okay.
Don't you go cheaping out on me.
Okay.
Get a good brand. You're gonna open these up.
Okay. And then
we're gonna dump them right into this bowl.
Okay. What's happening after that?
You are gonna get your hand into this and you have to crush them by hand.
That's kind of a thing. I've heard you talk about this.
Yes. So if you don't, I'm gonna show you that there's a little bit of liquid in here that
I'm not sure what to do with my hands.
Be good just to hold them down by your side.
You want to do it? Okay.
Yes, it was in my hands.
He's a big boy. I can let you do it.
It is my first cooking show.
Give me a little bit of credit.
I really just poured all in.
Yeah. Okay. I feel like I turned into my grandmother. And then
should we
them.
Switch? Because you're going to be doing stuff over here.
Can I? Sure.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Let's do that. I'm obviously going to give the old. Your cup got empty real fast.
Well,
what's going on there, sister?
You make me.
Okay,
dig.
So literally just in there.
Get in there with your hands. So the flavor I feel like, doesn't it feel amazing?
It feels like squishy, gross tomatoes.
You automatically feel like an old little Italian man. Yeah, you do.
I feel a little older and a little more Italian already.
Seriously.
You look it.
Thank you.
Now I'm going to just give you a little bit of basil leaf that we're just going to...
So I'm just like getting... I mean, I'm like mushing this up.
You're mushing.
Is there now, a certain amount of mushing I should not do?
Wow. That's what I was going to ask you. How do you like your tomato
sauce? You're going to ask me.
Do you like it chunky? Do you like... See, when I think of pizza, I go big.
Okay,
so
well then let's go big. Okay, these are
Here's
some
something
manly
you need
hands.
To know. He doesn't know.
Okay.
You tell him.
I think
what's
we're
good.
Probably good.
Have you ever had like an old school kind of Italian pizza?
A flatbread pizza?
Yeah, flatbread pizzas.
No.
Yeah.
Okay, so that would be good.
But so like we've got.
Will that bother you?
Oh gosh, no. I love tomatoes.
Okay, good. Then keep it like that.
Okay. So we're done.
Well, kinda.
Okay.
You're gonna clean off your hand, wipe it all over your pants or something.
Oh god.
But
did
use
you?
No.
Shirt.
I can use Michael's shirt.
Yeah, I'll help you out.
Thank you.
Well, now we have our tomatoes.
All right.
You're gonna salt them a little bit.
Okay.
I'll salt them for you because you're taking
that's a
too
good
long.
Idea.
And tomatoes love salt.
I just got the paper towel.
Right? Tomatoes love salt. Tomatoes also love fresh basil.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I already added just a little bit while you were smushing.
I saw that.
Is that the technical word, Betty? Smushing?
Smushing?
While you were smushing.
Yes. You were smooching with your brother.
You was here. And you were smooching with my brother.
They're doing quotes. I don't think
I can do.
What you're doing right here is called zhuzhing it up.
Right.
You zhuzh up.
This is the technical zhuzh. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So
now let's get them on to some heat.
Okay.
We gotta
turn our heat up over here. By the way, I turned it down a little bit. So we're cruising along with our 36-inch Blackstone air fryer.
I'm sure you already knew that.
Nope.
Nope.
He just saved your life.
Yeah, you're welcome.
So while he's zhuzhing that up and he's giving it a mix, we're just going to smash a little bit of garlic because every pizza sauce should be garlicky, right?
Yeah, I agree with you.
So I'm gonna have you.
I can
that,
do stuff.
Go ahead, peel that garlic.
Yep, I'm on it.
I can do stuff.
I can do things too.
What
I'm
we're gonna
a real life boy.
Are you?
Look, Geppetto, I'm a real live boy.
How long does it take you to usually peel garlic?
Well, how many licks does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop?
This is why.
One, a two, three.
A three.
It's
one, two, three.
It's worth it, though, to take
to
the time
it right.
to do this. Do
okay.
not skimp out and get jarred
so
garlic.
So are we going to cut this up, or are we just going to leave it? We're just going to leave it like this?
Yep. And you don't have to put it on your pizza. It's just going to flavor our tomatoes.
Oh,
so,
I see what's going on.
We'll start. You grab those garlic cloves.
I'm almost done.
And I'll grab the extra virgin olive oil, and we're going to just saute that just for like 30 seconds before we dump those tomatoes
okay.
in.
Okay. All right. Here we are. Garlic into the saucepan.
You put a little bit of skin in there.
Yeah, dude.
Idiot.
Come on,
man. All right, I got it.
Oh, that.
Idiot!
What now?
30 seconds for that, and you're gonna dump that in.
Okay.
Okay, so.
Wait, so we're hanging out for a minute?
Yeah, this just goes into the garlic oil.
Yep, that's it. It's so simple, so easy. Easier, I think, than dumping a can of pizza.
I don't know if it's easier than that. Get real.
So if you,
that's really easy.
If you
come on,
do
Prego.
Pizza on a Friday night.
It's a ragu.
Don't do that to me. If you guys do pizza on a Friday night.
JK kidding.
Hey. JK kidding.
Oh, we're going.
Go.
I was gonna ring the bell, but
go then.
Let's just go.
We go.
I'm going.
I'm gone.
Go then.
I am.
Go.
I'm gone.
Go then.
I am.
So
whoa,
hey,
you
going
just
in right
go.
Now?
Just hanging out back there.
All right.
Come on, guy.
Boys, we're going in.
Whoa.
Oh, jeez.
It's all right. It's a little bit messy, and that's cool.
Okay. All of it?
Well, that's good.
Probably
that's
enough,
good.
Right?
Yep, that's good.
Because we don't want to be.
And now we're just gonna let that hang out.
Let it hang.
Yep.
All right.
That looks beautiful.
So, okay, what now? Are we...
Oh, we do need to add one more thing.
No. Welcome to a Betty's Kitchen, where we forget everything.
How the turntables have...
Well. How the turntables...
Okay, listen. These boys are just throwing my brain.
Oh, we're
off.
Messing with your mojo.
I'm trying to.
You gotta have mojo, baby.
Oh, you always need oregano in a pizza sauce, correct?
That makes sense.
I believe it's pronounced oregano.
Well, I say
just
oregano.
Kidding.
So...
I'm kidding. I'm kidding with you.
Do it.
Oh, I get to do it. All right.
Yes. Yes.
So we're not measuring.
Nope.
I never measure.
So that's the last thing.
Go.
Oh,
go.
Going. Tell
that's
me when.
Good, that's
oh, jeez.
Wow.
That's good.
She was saying
no.
go, and I was like,
that was close, man.
It's perfect.
Whoa. That was close.
Let's take a break and take a ring.
Can we all
calm yourself?
Can we take a ring?
Can we take a ring?
Betty needs to learn the lingo. Ring it
so,
and bring it.
How about when the boys come to?
Wait a minute, I just realized something.
What?
One. To who?
Oh.
I'll just have a ketchup packet
they
or two.
Forgot about you.
I'll just have a sugar packet or two.
I can actually hear you getting fatter.
Oh, I can actually hear you getting fatter.
Wait, hey.
Do you want a sip?
I don't have anything.
I'm gonna have you chop up
okay.
some garlic.
Yep, I can do that. So, I mean, I can just do your normal method, right?
Yep, smash.
Okay.
Keep, you know, you...
I do know. I got this. It's not my first cooking show.
Yeah. Well,
or is it?
It is.
It's not just a clever name.
But it's not just a clever name.
Right. Okay.
Now, you could use a grater if you wanted to. However, today we're doing a little
you
bit
know,
of a chop.
You know, I never do your grater trick with
I
garlic.
Love
we should do it.
It.
If only we had a grater.
Yeah.
And somebody would have remembered
wait,
to bring it out.
Were we supposed to have a grater?
We were supposed to have a grater, which means there's not one out here. And what does that qualify as? If you have to go get said grater
no.
from another location other than the set.
He's chopping the garlic. Nathan, will you go get the grater for me?
See,
please?
That is a load of crap.
Why? But
why is it a load of crap?
Everybody should have to take their own freaking walk of shame.
Not
I've
me.
Taken plenty.
Hey, Betty.
Not me.
What? I would love to go get that for you.
You're the best.
See, that's what I'm...
Does that count?
Somebody has to take the walk of shame. Somebody pays the price. Hey, guy. Hey, guy, where you been?
Hey, ask me if I care.
Hey, do you care?
That was very nice of you. I mean, he just gave you, like, a break from having to chop all that garlic.
So why do we do this versus chopping? Is it just the consistency that's going to be better?
I think two things. It's a laziness from my own self, but also
I like
it
moves.
So small that it kind of disappears to where my kids can't really see
that's how I
feel
about
in their mouth.
Prego.
No. And you know, I guarantee you Prego uses jarred garlic.
Yummy.
No. Totally different flavor.
Yummy.
Yummy.
Okay. Yummy.
This is also something like this kind of oil right here. Perfect.
Oh, wait, show me that, dude.
That's sufficient.
Me... Wow.
Look at that. It's my first garlic mincing. What's next?
Drizzle some oil in there.
Okay.
This is would be the same kind of thing. That's good.
Okay.
Some crushed red pepper and some oregano.
So we're going to spice it up a little bit. Mm-hmm. How much heat do you like? Because I am a fan of heat.
When it comes to crushed red pepper, I like a lot.
Okay, good. So let's go. Tell me when we reach a lot status.
How do you like? That's good for me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. A little bit of oregano.
Yes.
Okay. I kind of could guess.
See,
so this one, we're just going to just a mild dusting.
Don't
oh, continue. Going yeah, past go. A
That's
dust.
Good.
Okay.
That's good. So this is what we drizzle first onto our pizza and last onto our pizza, as you'll see. Also, this would be a fabulous oil to dip your bread in. You can add a little bit of grated Parmesan cheese.
Can I get that garlic
cheese.
In? Yes. Behind the ears, yes. Hussy said, I do the hustle. Do the hustle. Do we need to mix this?
Mix it up. There you go, that's it.
Oh, I see bubbles happening back there. Is that a good thing?
Tiny bubbles in the wine.
Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Actually, Nate, you did a similar thing the other day, but we did no... crushing of tomatoes.
All right, what's next? All right, keep
pizza.
This guy in line.
Ready?
Yeah, let's go.
So, I don't know, what do you usually use? Stone fire?
You know I'm a flatbread pizza kind of guy, and it always...
I think it's one of the best out there.
Always go stone fire.
We'll do one.
That's the way to do it.
Do you like oil down on yours?
I typically do, but
okay,
honestly, you're
that.
On my you're on my show teaching me, so I'll do whatever.
So no
let's
oil.
Let's do everything.
Should we say flatbread
upside down? No, it's
pizza
not flatbread.
Or flatbread pizza?
Well...
Flatbread pizza.
Nope.
Pizza.
Thank you.
Whose show is this anyway?
What's a flatbread to you versus what's a pizza to you?
It's
I don't
the
even
dough.
Know what you're saying. Like, what are you saying to me right now?
Okay, upside down with the pizza.
I don't even
yeah,
know
we gotta
you.
Turn it on.
I don't even know you.
Who are you? What are you doing?
Who are you? I don't even know you. Go away, mister.
I didn't turn it.
This is your cooking show. Come on.
But it's my first show.
All right, nice and low.
I always forget things.
Go upside down.
Okay, no oil.
I like it.
No oil, nice and dry. What we're doing is trying to make a crispy pizza. So we're going to crisp the top up. It's going to be not like...
Whoa.
Oh, hey, Michael.
New camera guy.
Hey, hey there,
new.
Hello.
All right, so now we've got our flatbread going over there for our pizza.
Nice and crispy and ready to
we've
load.
We've got our oil. Talk
like
to me.
While they're talking, I... Went and got myself a drink.
Oh, Betty, ring it.
Why would you drink it by yourself?
How about I?
You guys did.
All right.
Okay, so.
No, you drink it after you ring it. It's not complicated.
Oh my God.
You see what I deal with, Betty?
So
you
I think
change
I
your mind a little
go,
bit.
Back to the family style. He's such a pain in my butt. Let's talk toppings. I don't know what kind of pizza cheese you like for your pizza. I'm
going
to guess, if I had to guess, it would be out of a bag and pre-shred it, correct? To go on top of that Prego.
You know me
so well.
Right.
I always love to add a fresh mozzarella on the top.
What's that at?
Mozzarella.
You're welcome.
I don't say it like that, but
yeah,
mozzarella
so,
ball.
So what are we going to do with this here? Are
bigger?
We cutting it up or what are we doing?
You're going to create me some little mozzarella pearls since I couldn't find mozzarella pearls
I
here
wait
in
to do
Tampa.
That.
Mozzarella pearls.
If I only had a knife.
And my head, I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching if I
only I'm really had excited a knife. To see how you make pearls out of this.
Well.
Just do like shapes because the
shapes.
Thing is.
Yeah, just shapes, you know.
Here, do you want me
no.
to
No,
shapes.
Okay. I will.
He won't even let me try to cook anything.
What are you talking about? You're teaching
not
me.
Not slices.
Oh,
okay, we could do slices. No. Actually, that's good. We could do like, it would end up looking like a margarita pizza.
Okay.
So now that you
all right,
have
so
that
do
finish,
I have like sufficient shapes here? Slices?
I love it. This is perfect.
Okay,
everything
good.
Smells so good.
Yes,
kinda
it does.
Kind of like grandma's kitchen.
Okay.
Now, two things. You're
okay.
going to flip your pizza crust, and then we're going to get this beautiful pepperoni sizzling up on the griddle.
Use your fingers.
Nah, dude.
Nah, dude.
I got it. Okay.
Okay.
Beauty.
Here we go.
Like that.
Let's get some pepperoni down.
Oh, literally meat first.
No, pepperoni on the griddle.
Okay, so I can just drop it around. Okay, so the pepperoni's down.
Okay, now provolone. Get a handful of this provolone and put it all around that pizza.
Wow, first.
first, see, because we're doing like an upside down pizza. Oh, that's one so thing I cool. notice about your pizza or your flatbread.
Is that I do them you traditionally?
You always put cheese on the top, but not.
I
like,
don't.
This is like glue. Like get it to the edge.
Oh, glue.
All around, and okay. then in the middle too.
Okay.
I like this trick.
I'm gonna be excited about
so
this.
Actually, that cheese is gonna protect the dough from getting soggy.
Exactly, Nate.
Dang.
Genius.
Exactly, Nate.
Nate.
What we need to do is ladle on that hot sauce.
Okay. On top of.
Without trying to get all that saucy sauce.
Without.
Get the tomatoes. Yeah.
I gotcha.
You know what I mean? Because yep. you don't want to drown your pizza.
Gotcha. So I'm slightly like straining almost, right?
Yeah, and like kind of smear it, okay. you know? Just like you would your
like
prego.
A bagel and schmear.
Please forgive me for not praying before I had a bite of my bagel and schmear.
Men smear.
Men smear. Smear, that's it.
Hey, did I do a sufficient job
You're
of crushing the tomatoes?
You were doing so good.
Okay, thank you.
I like them chunky like that. I
do
too. I don't know about you.
Yep,
I
do.
You yeah. guys like your tomatoes? That's perfect. Stop.
Okay, okay, I'm stopping.
Grab
I'm
this
stopping.
Mozzarella.
Mozzarella, you mean?
Mozzarella.
Okay.
Grab it. Put it, spread out.
Grab it real good.
Yes.
Okay.
All around.
We're back.
Now listen, mozzarella has a lot of moisture in it, so you don't want to put it too close because you don't want to get all that liquid, you know?
Okay, so.
It's going to spread out.
Okay, all right.
And then we're going to get that pepperoni that's all nice and griddled up on that pizza.
Okay, is that enough or should I put?
How about you eat one and I eat one?
Oh, cheers. Really? Okay.
Now place it all around nice and pretty.
Nice and pretty?
Yep. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Flip that one.
So you want the crispy side facing up.
Yes, exactly.
So we're going to pepperoni. What are we going to do after this?
You're going to just let it hang out and do its thing.
You like to let food hang out.
I do, because you know why? Because I like to ring it in and bring it in.
Oh, see? Whoa. She's in the game.
All right.
She's back.
She's back in the game.
Back in the game.
No, this is just us.
Whoa! All right, I got it. Yeah. Right. Okay.
Let it hang out. I mean.
No dome.
You're outside.
No ambient heat.
Viva las biodome.
No.
Hey, speaking of viva los biodome, did you see Todd catching the mahi mahi?
Yes.
Free the mahi mahi.
Free mahi mahi. Free mahi mahi.
Dude, you see what I did there?
I do.
Time to take the pizza off.
It's that time.
It's pizza
okay.
time.
Okay. So just like,
okay. Put it right here.
Here we go.
I'll make you a little bit of room.
All right. Let's see if I can.
You ready?
That's Ooh. Good looking pizza.
Okay, any flop?
No floppage.
No flop.
Well, then your job's done. Come on.
I really would hate to lose this.
Oh, please don't.
I know.
Oh,
doesn't that
hello.
Look like
beautiful.
Heaven? Now, there's only a couple more things we need to do.
Okay.
Is to, what's my favorite word?
Zhuzh. Let's go to Zhuzh Town.
So, yes.
Population.
Try to get.
Ouch Town, population you, bro.
That garlic that you chopped up
or
that you grated up and your pepper and a little bit of the oil.
Oh, I'm drizzling
not
on?
Not too much. Yeah. It'll make it that little bit of heat.
Okay.
Love it. Doesn't it smell good?
I love it.
Okay, good.
No, I'm adoring.
I thought you were going like, I don't know.
No, of course.
He was umming.
I know. This this to me smells like a Friday night growing
if,
up.
If I was Michael perfect. Greenlee, I would go.
Grab some basil and do your thing.
What is my? Oh, my thing is.
Your thing.
You gotta make it
you
look
know,
pretty.
You know, the thing you do.
Well,
obviously.
This is the thing you're gonna be doing from now on at home.
Well, that makes perfect sense.
You think your kids and wife would like this?
Probably
not your kids.
No, my daughter,
but,
Mila, that's a. It's that's too big.
You wanna do your favorite thing?
Oh.
What is it?
Chiffonade?
Yeah. Chiffonade it.
Shall I?
He's really good at chiffonade.
Definitely his thing, Betty.
Shut up, Nate.
I learned how to,
It's 100% my thing.
Chiffonade from CJ.
Hey! See? That's what I'm talking about, man.
I'm just kidding.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, so we're not doing the big leaves. We're doing...
No, we can take that one off.
We're going to get rid of the big leaf.
Yes.
Because that's not beautiful.
And this stem.
No.
And then you just make it look pretty.
Okay. I got you. Hold on. Let me release the Kraken.
Release the Kraken.
Mm-hmm. It's not very pretty, is it?
It is. What are you talking
about?
It is about?
Pretty.
Is it pretty enough?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh,
okay, I
yes.
just didn't want to like disappoint. If
Heck
it was
no.
too clumpy.
The more.
Oh, I want to know.
Are you happy with your haircut?
All I care about is, are you happy with your haircut?
I'm very happy.
Are you?
Good work,
very
dude.
Happy.
I mean, you did that all by yourself.
You did it. You did it.
I did it.
You did good.
I'm good enough.
You're good enough. Now you beat me to
it. Smart enough. And doggone it.
Doggone it. People like me.
And doggone it. People like me.
Ready? Watch. Listen to the crunch.
Oh. Oh. Oh, what are you doing, madman?
Let me just tell you one thing. A pizza should not be perfect.
Garth, have you got a second?
It almost looks as good as a DiGiorno.
No flop. No, every piece should be a different size.
Beauty.
If you had a pizza cutter, you could do it like... But we don't do
that. What else you could do?
Just continue cutting
it.
Oh, jeez. Okay. You made me nervous there for a
second. Let's do it all the way Nate wants to do it. Okay. I cannot wait to cook with him next. He's such a perfectionist.
Cool. Let's do everything you want to do. Try it.
I just want to do things that I want to do.
Let's do everything you want to do.
Let's do everything you want to do, Nate.
A little more pizzazz.
No, Nate, just
do everything you want to do.
Let's do all the things that you want to do.
Let's do everything you want to do.
You just whispered too.
Just the last part. The emphasis on the syllable.
Okay, look. I mean,
you put the wrong emphasis on the wrong syllable.
Pizza. You guys can quote your movies and play with your G.I. Joes and stuff.
Hey. Your G.I. Joes.
They are American
your
heroes,
Star
you know.
Star Wars models, your little gidgets and gadgets you got here.
They are not dolls. They're action figures.
They're not dolls. They're action figures.
Uh-huh. Mm. Nom.
That crunch. I love how crunchy that crust gets. Mm.
Okay, I'm not gonna joke around.
Yeah?
I owe it to my viewers.
Are you sure?
I owe it to my viewers
to
always be transparent. That sauce is so much better than jarred. No kidding. So much better.
Guess what piece I got?
The garlic. Yeah.
It's so good.
That's stunning.
All right, I'm having
You're never
bite.
Gonna use Prego again or a jarred sauce, right? Mm. Look how easy that was.
Oh, no, he didn't.
He
didn't.
Derek is my brother.
He's my brother.
I cannot do any more of your movie quotes.
But could you handle comments? Because I do believe it's that time.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for CJ's favorite comments of the week.
Starting in no particular order from the top. This is from Alan Bazaar.
How bizarre.
Ooh, baby.
Making me crazy.
Hey, all right. I'm going to ring just because we got her in it.
Finally.
Okay. Here we go. This is from
Alan. We haven't even gotten into the comments yet.
That burger looks slap yo mama good with a deep southern Louisiana saying. Need to wear an apron to eat it. Juicy, sloppy, lots of napkins.
My kind of burger.
I just love sloppy, extra sloppy. Sloppy Joe's, what are you gonna do? Okay, here we go. Number two, this is from Southern Adventures. Triple B, burnt bacon boy.
Kind of dumb, but all right.
Love your show, CJ. Nate, not too much.
All right, this guy sucks.
JK, smiley face. Yeah, I'm gonna ring to that one.
Okay.
Of course we are.
Jeez, I know it was sarcasm.
Cool. Of course it was.
Yeah.
Dr. Wiggs Blad?
Yeah.
Wiggis Blad. Or Dr. Wiggis Blad.
Not
gonna work anymore, that's for sure.
Not gonna work here anymore anyway.
Welcome to CJ's most current Burn the Bacon show.
Yep.
Sorry, dude, had to. Final score, I'll take two, with a side of rings and a spicy dill pickle. Oh, and a nice vanilla shake.
Okay, it's a good idea. You should do an episode.
With that. Basically that.
Yeah.
Okay, here we
Sounds
go.
Sounds fun.
Gonna ring that one. There we are. Thank you. Crystal, this comes from Crystal Azara. So happy to hear you sing, CJ. Although, I'm a little disappointed that you didn't say my name like we agreed. It's true.
Did you agree?
She likes
like
to hear
two
her name from
episodes
you.
Ago, I said every time I sing, I would sing Crystal. What's the song I should sing?
Every time I look around.
Crystal.
Every time I look around.
No?
In
no.
my face.
Crystal. Crystal, my dear.
Thank you, Crystal.
Cheers to you, darling.
Cheers indeed.
I'm always singing to you in my heart, no matter what.
Yes.
This is from Jimmy Doyle. We're going to kind of try to do
a little...
Jimmy! Hey, Jimmy. A great show, guys. Love the movie clips. Makes me laugh and gets more ideas for and get more ideas for cooking. Awesome. P.S. E is the nerd. Dot 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 dot.
Ain't that the truth?
Here we go. Oh, Tyler Payne. Here we go.
Again with the Tyler
Dude,
Payne.
Dude, I can't stop. I can't stop with this guy. Two things. Number one, CJ is becoming a better cook each episode.
True.
Thank you, Betty.
Thanks to me.
From nice skills to general management of the recipe. Thank you, Betty. Number two, the loose meat sandwich is just code for going commando.
Oh, no.
I don't make this up.
Oh, no.
You got to snort. We got to snort. All right. I was not going to ring right away and try to speed through it, but come on. We got to ring to the snort. Here we go. Okay, this is from Todd. This turned out fantastic. My kids gave it a rating of 8.3. Thank you, CJ.
Is that Todd Tobin?
No.
Oh.
But thank you. Patricia, this is good. I want this on video. My 12-month-old dances every time I watch the show and the theme song hits. And sometimes I even bust into my kids' room in the mornings singing the theme song to wake them up for school. Aww. LOL. This is from Lance Dean. Thank you for taking me to Lunch Ladyland with the Sloppy Joes.
You know
are
that
so
one, right?
Very welcome, Lance.
Sloppy Joe, Sloppy Joe.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Adam Sandler.
Yes.
Jeff and Sherry, or Cherry.
Baby loves me, yes, she does.
Says, once again, just awesome, CJ. Love your ideas. Keep them coming. Robert, just below that, says, I love Mountain Dew. I will try a Sloppy Joe.
Oh. Ew. He's right up there with Glenn.
Steven, well, me and my 5-year-old son just watched this, and now he wants a Sloppy Joe cake for his birthday.
Okay.
Thank you for that, CJ. Ooh. Now I have to figure that one out. Sloppy Joe's
for life. Or you don't.
This is from Crystal and Keto, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Yeah.
My Blackstone arrived today, and naturally, I've been binge-watching Blackstone cooking videos for the past week. Sorry, this is going to sting a little. You, my friends, are by far the most entertaining, and I'm only one video in. Love all the movie quote references.
Was that
kind of people.
Me too.
You have a new subscriber in me. Faux show.
Me too.
You too.
Me too.
You too.
She did say it was her first video in.
The first video out of ours.
BBC
she had been binge watching.
Todd yet.
No, that's true. Don't you worry. The bell was rung.
Check
we just ring it.
Check out me and Todd.
I guess. Yeah. And ladies and gentlemen, that is it for this week's episode of CJ's Favorite Comments of the Week. Betty, we did it.
You like the pizza.
I freaking adore the pizza.
Also,
are you kidding me?
While we cut, I snagged one.
I
Sorry.
See
it's
this.
It's so good. And you like it?
We have people behind you that are waiting for the pizza. So go to blackstoneproducts.com. Be sure to watch Betty's show, Family Style, Todd's show, The Tobin Zone, which we lovingly call it, but it's actually called Let's Give It a Try. Nate's show, where all of your dreams don't come true, which is filmed over there. Cook, eat, repeat. Again and again and again.
I think I'm going to go over there.
What?
Hey!
There's like less quoting and more cooking over there, so I'm going to take a couple pieces of pizza with
my
me and
stars?
Nate, you want to go cook something?
Yes!
Guess I'll just be here eating pizza by myself, hoping somebody watches my show. If you like, subscribe, or whatever we said a little while ago.
Huh?
I just...
What?
Hey,
huh?
This is my show where we cook and we quote.
Huh?
But nobody...
Yeah!